This video is about power management. I will show you a couple of things for how to properly set up your PSU and how to control the power in your rig so you don't have any problems with your cards, and because sometimes the cards stop mining, and this is usually a problem. 99% is a problem with the way you design the power management and the power for your rig. Also, it's very important to kind of control and monitor your the settings from your rig. So all the Ethos software, they have an API which you can use to monitor your rig, and also you can get notifications. Ethos doesn't have this by default, so you have to build by yourself. So I will make another video to show you how I did it. I create a Python script which monitor the API, and if the value of, for example, the hash value is lower than the current value, then you get an email. So I will show you just a small kind of taste how it looks like. So for example, this one is a kind of basic HTML page with a couple of options from the API. For example, this is the hash per GPU. So when you click that, you get this. So this is the API in JSON format. And then this is the current condition. So this is what the API report, 28.3 hash per GPU. My notification is for the 25. So when it reaches 25, this will go. It will send me an email notification. And also, I have all the options which I need to make sure the rig is working properly. So. For example, another important thing is the mining condition of the rig. So you can see the last check time was 3rd of August, 9 o'clock. That's again the API JSON format. This is the current condition as reported by the API, and this is the notification is for mining. So if it's in that case, if it's coming, if reporting something different than mining, that the word mining will send me an email, and I will show you also, probably you have seen it, but I will show you how the API looks like. So this is the API in JSON. You can pick up anything you want from here, and you can use it to notify you for differences, for changes. So I will make another video and give more details how I create the script, the Python script, and also I will put the script in GitHub so everyone can download it and use it. So for now, let's go back to power management. So power management, as I said, is very important to keep your rig up and running, and especially to keep your cards mining. So this is my first EVGA 1600. This is the card, the PSU I bought at the beginning, to connect 6 GPUs, to connect 6 risers, and also I have here 6 fans, and of course the hard drive PSU CPU. So at the beginning I connected everything like this. So I took the hard drive, I connected to SATA 1, and then I connect the CPU, and then I start plugging all the cards. So the GPU cards are going straight to the GPU slots. So with this way, I thought is a best solution, and of course this is 1600 watt gold edition. So I thought it would be okay, but I will show you later on why it wasn't okay. So I plug in 6 cards here, and then I had another 3 VGA slots empty. So I decided to put here the risers with the VGA cables as coming from the PSU. So I put them here, and then I left with 2 SATA and 2 peripherals. The peripherals, the VAT from this card, from this port, is very low, cannot be used for risers. So I just plug in the fans. 3 here. And 3 here. So the fans, they have the cables where you can connect 3 fans in parallel, and there is one cable with 3 fan slots. So 3 fans are using one cable. That cable goes to this port, the peripheral one. The other cable, again in parallel, connects 3 fans and goes back to here, back to this parallel. The MB is the main cable which connect the PSU with the motherboard. That's, it's not that important at the moment. And then I left with 3 risers. So the only way, I didn't want to connect the risers to another power supply. So I just plug in here with SATA. So I plug in here with 2 cables. So I put here 2 here. So 2 in SATA here, 1 there. So this I just use the cables from SATA to with the adapter to connect the risers. So the rig was okay like this for a while, so for a couple of weeks and probably months, up to the version 1.128, Ethos version. After 1.28, Ethos, they made many changes, especially on the power and how AMD cards are using and utilize the power from the PSU, and of course how improving the hashing. So when I update the Ethos to 1.30 and they make all these improvements and a couple of bug fixes, then I start having problems with the cards. I spoke with Ethos, and then of course they said there's a problem with the risers. 99% they are right. Usually the problem is with the setup in your rig, because definitely they test the software, they check all the improvements. So I decided to make some changes and see what happens, because with this setup I was losing a card every week, and that was annoying to restart the rig quickly. So what I did, I bought another EVGA, smaller watts, 750, and I brought it here. Let's see, it goes up. Yeah, there. So I decided to use this PSU for to connect the cards and the risers which create problem. For example, I decided to leave the 3 fans and the other 3 here, because this is a small voltage, it doesn't create problem. And then I moved the risers directly to the VGA, just to make sure that I'm getting the right power. Because ideal is to connect the risers with the VGA ports to make sure that the power is enough to the power that the riser gets is enough for the functionality. Because the riser, even if it needs probably 40-50 watts, which not always 40 or 50, can be more, can be less, so you need about 20% more. So I plug in 3 risers here, So I released the two SATA from this PSU just to help with the power. And also I decided to take one of the cards. So I did like this. Since I split the load between two EVGA PSUs, then the whole rig was more stable. Now I can keep the rig for about 2-3 months with no problem. But ideal is to restart your rig every kind of probably every month, because you can see from the graph, from your pool graph, that after a couple of weeks the hashing is going up and down like too much. Like it's not ideal to keep the rig for too long with no reboot. So I've seen a couple of times when I restart the rig after a couple of weeks, the hashing in pool is kind of flat, is more stable, and I don't see a lot of errors. So it's good practice to restart once a month and make sure the reporting hash is very good in your pool. So this is the setup, my current setup, which improved the quality of the hashing and also the quality of the functionality of the rig. And also I will show you, so this is my rig here. Oops. This is my rig, so you can see at the moment my watt is about 130, and also I have 170 hash. I flash the cards, so with the flashing I got about 30 to 40 hash more total. So if you have AMD cards, definitely it worth to flash your cards, and I have another video for this. You can, if you want to flash your cards, you can watch it. So yeah, but if you calculate, like for example, I give you an example here. So let's say you plug in your cards in one PSU and you do the calculation, 130 multiplied 6, so 780, let's say 800, and then you adding another 200-300 watt for the rest, for the risers, probably more than 300 watt. So we say about 1200 watt. But even with 1200 watt and my EVGA is 1600, I had problems with one of the cards. And before I buy the EVGA 750, I swap a couple of risers, I check the cables, but it didn't solve the problem. So so the solution was to share the load between two EVGA. Another setup you can have if you want, you can have a small PSU like this one here. And you can connect your CPU, you can connect your fans, you can connect the hard drive if you want to, and a couple of risers here, and then you can use the big one just for the graphic cards. Or you can have a couple of graphic cards in a good PSU, and like I have it here, and then another graphic card with a couple of risers and another PSU. So now if you have six cards like this setup and you want to have another, to buy another six cards, so you want to make 12 cards rig, probably what you would do. So one of the options is to buy another 1600 EVGA. So you can connect your six cards, the new six cards in the new EVGA, and then you can connect your three risers, and the remaining three risers you can plug in the small PSU by using SATA, and then you have to play with the load, because for example if you bring more risers in this small EVGA, you have to remove the card back to here, and probably if that creates problems, you can remove the CPU and the hard drive, and then you can use the other two SATA for all the peripheral for the main risers. So the ideal plan is to have two PSU and play with the load, move the stuff around until you make it stable, and yeah, and this will solve probably 99% of the problem. So this is about power management. General rule is you have to control and manage the load of your system, and if you have problems, you must use another PSU to set the load and make sure that the rig doesn't strangle to support your system. So it's very important to do your calculation based on the watt that your card is using, which you can get from your Ethos, and then add another 20%, and then the risers they're using around 40 to 50 watts, maybe 60 maximum, and then the rest is just a couple of watts, like the CPU, the hard drive, and the fans. So when you summarize all that, you can share the load, and you can decide how many you need to connect to one card, one PSU, how many you want to connect to the other one, and then if you have a problem, you can keep swapping between the two until you fix all the problem and you get a stable rig. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned with my next video where I'll show you how you can monitor your rig with a Python script, and you can put the script in any cloud service you want, and you can use it to notify you for any change in your script by using the very good API from Ethos. Thank you for watching. Bye.